Based on construction differences, iPhone screens differ in refurbishment methods. iPhone 11 and XR use LCD screens and full screen design. What is the right way to refurbish an iPhone 11 screen? As we can see, the amount of OCA between the cover and the touch is small, which causes a narrow gap between them. Directly separating the cover would damage the touch. The skill set requirement is extremely high, therefore, it is more efficient to separate the touch directly after removing the bezel. Today, RayLab will show you how to solve the two major problems of iPhone 11 screen refurbishment through concrete operations. One is how to safely remove the bezel of the full LCD screen, and the other is how to separate the touch properly. Let's get started. As we can see, this iPhone 11's touch function is not working. We decided to refurbish it. First, test the phone's display function. And the test result is normal. Next, we proceed to bezel removal, and unscrew the screen protector with a screwdriver. Remove the touch cable. Slowly remove the protective iron sheet in the direction of the cables. Adjust the heating pad temperature to 200 degrees Celsius. Place the screen bezel close to the edge of the heating pad and heat it. Remove the camera induction coil. Use a cutting nipper to cut the bezel from the induction coil position. Slowly peel off the bezel. Note, to avoid damaging the LCD, the bezel in the cable area should be to be torn horizontally outwards. Heat the screen after removing the bezel. At 100 degrees Celsius on the NJLD screen separation machine. Remove the earpiece bracket. The LCD gold wire enters from the touch layer and gradually separates the cover from the touch by pulling it from side to side. Note, when the wire passes through the touch cable position, we need to gently lift the golden wire around it. Enter the golden wire again for complete separation. After the separation, use an electric glue remover to remove the glue. Add several naphtha to the sponge to clean the residual glue. Use naphtha with a dust-free cloth to clean it again. After cleaning the glue, place the LCD into the alignment mold horizontally. Use a dust-free cloth to thoroughly clean the LCD. Apply repart front glass with touch. Use a stick to tear down the protective film. Place it in the alignment mold. Convert the alignment mold and remove the screen. Place the mold and screen into the ReFox FM50 for lamination. After lamination, take out the screen and debubble it. Next, install the protective iron sheet. Tear off the touch cable protective sticker. Attach the touch cable to the protective iron sheet. And then tear off the other protective stickers. Screw on the iron protective sheet. Finally, we use S300 to test touch and display performance. The functions are normal. The refurbishment is complete. Depending on the different types of screens, we have different points to notice when laminating and separating the screen. That's all for today. Choosing the right tools, the proper operation method, quality supplies and constantly practicing can significantly improve your screen refurbishment efficiency. If you are interested in how we operate, you are welcome to join Rayway Academy for learning. You can also check the tools and supplies used in the video on the detail page. Please feel free to leave your comments in the comments section for your opinions and suggestions about this video. Thanks for watching.